Hey everyone, ScoreJ2 here, and welcome back to a brand new playthrough. This time around, it's the 2007 game Portal, brought to us by Valve and available on Steam. So anyone that has not heard of this game or has not had a chance to play it, go do so right now. I was actually one of the few who had heard of the game but had never played it up until just recently, and I'm sorry I hadn't, because this is a really fun first-person perspective puzzle game where you take the role of a character by the name of Chell through the Aperture Science Enrichment Center, and you have to navigate a series of rooms using what's called the Aperture Science Portal Gun. There's not much to be said about this other than what we're going to learn throughout the game, so I'm just going to go ahead and start one real quick here. Go ahead and start a new game. We'll get some cool music. So we're waking up. Yeah. We can move around with the WSAND keys. You can see the shitter there. I'm gonna grab this radio. Countdown timer. You can jump with the space bar, you can crouch with the control
Hello,
key.
And, again, welcome to the Aperture Science Computer-Aided Enrichment Center. We hope your brief detention in the relaxation vault has been a pleasant one. Your specimen has been processed, and we are now ready to begin the test proper. Before we start, however, keep in mind that although fun and learning are the primary goals of all Enrichment Center activities, serious injuries may occur. For your own safety and the safety of others, please refrain from. Stand back. The portal will open in 3, 2, 1.
Alright, so here is the introduction to what this game is all about, and that's the portals. So, as you can see here, the orange portal and the blue portal are the links between each other, and as we progress further on, we're going to have to use those in a creative sense in order to solve some of these puzzles. So let's go ahead and get going, and I'm going to take the cool tunes with us. I don't know what this is, but apparently it's an achievement. Use E to pick up an object. We're gonna pick up this cube and drop it off here.
Excellent. Please proceed into the chamber lock after completing each test. First, however, note the incandescent particle field across the exit. This Aperture Science material emancipation grill will vaporize any unauthorized equipment that passes through it. For instance, the Aperture Science weighted storage cube.
Uh-huh. So, I may be saving quite a bit throughout this playthrough, most notably because this particular game, for some reason with the Half-Life 2 engine, causes some problems when I play on my system and it crashes every now and then, so I don't like to have to repeat things over and over again. But let's go ahead and jump on down here.
So please place the weighted storage cube on the 1500 megawatt Aperture Science Heavy Duty Super Colliding Super Button.
Super button. Give me the cube. Going.
Perfect. Please move quickly to the chamber lock, as the effects of prolonged exposure to the button are not part of this test.
Everything is nonsense, and that's amazing. That's why this game is so fun. And with the upcoming release of Portal 2, coming up in a couple of weeks here, what better time than to go through this?
You're doing very well. Please be advised that a noticeable taste of blood is not part of any test protocol, but is an unintended side effect of the Aperture Science Material Emancipation Grill, which may, in semi-rare cases, emancipate dental fillings, crowns, tooth enamel, and teeth.
Give me a portal, fool. There we go. Yes! It's mine!
Very good. You are now in possession of the Aperture Science handheld portal device. With it, you can create your own portals. These intradimensional gates have proven to be completely safe. The device, however, has not. Do not touch the operational end of the device. Do not look directly at the operational end of the device. Do not submerge the device in liquid, even partially. Most importantly, under no circumstances should you...
Yeah. So... the portal device launches the portal, and as we can tell, we only have the blue portal now, so I can't shoot the orange one, but every time you launch the portal, the corresponding orange one will be the pathway through that. So if I launch it here, I can now go to where the orange one is, and vice versa. It will also be noted that there are certain surfaces that you can't attach the portal to, like metal. So like if I launch it here or on the glass, I can't launch it there. Certain flooring and ceilings can't have it launched there. So if you look at the crosshairs, you can see that the little ovals surrounding the crosshair, when they're filled in, then you have a valid target. If not, then you can't fire the portal. So that'll become necessary later to consider that. What I was doing earlier was I was taking the cameras off the walls.
To ensure the safe performance of all authorized activities, do not destroy vital testing apparatus.
It's not necessary, but it's fun to fuck with the devices.
Safety, do not destroy vital testing apparatus.
Let's take this radio with us. Alright, now where do we go? Transmission received. So I'm not exactly sure what this is doing. I'm making some achievement progress by doing this, like taking the cameras off the walls. It's not necessary. It's just fun. But those little radios, if you walk to a certain point in each level, then you can get a transmission. And I'm going to see if I can do that for some of them. Some of the radios are hard to get, though. So it's, you know, I may or may not waste time doing it. But we'll see. It's fun! Everyone laugh! It's fun! There's some cool shit you can do with the with both portals once you get it, but we're not gonna get the other one for a little while yet.
The chamber lock. Mind the gap.
And stop destroying my cameras.
Certain objects may be vital to your success. Do not destroy testing apparatus.
No one cares. So, one thing you have to take note of is now that we have to get across that, but we don't have another portal, we always use the one that's given to us.
Well done. Remember, the Aperture Science Bring Your Daughter to Work Day is the perfect time to have her tested.
And that's... apparently that's the right way to go. Let's go. Right now I'm just kind of screwing around, so... really curious how that works. Let's go up. Up there. I can hear it. That's kind of fun. Searching for this shit. And I fell. Like I said, I don't know how much time I'm gonna spend wasting doing this, but. Drop the stupid thing, haha! Yeah, I wish I knew what I was doing with this. Boom. That's not over there. How about over here? Nope. There it is. See, that's all it takes is a little perseverance, guys. Let's take the camera with us. We'll go through this stupid thing with the camera. Vaporized. I like taking a long time for stuff. It's part of using the old noggin. And because this game is pretty short, you want to get everything you can out of it.
Welcome to Test Chamber 4. You're doing quite well.
I am, aren't I? Get off my butt. Hey, we can see ourselves. That's some of the cool effects. Drop my radio. There it is. Get my cue back.
Once again, excellent work. As part of our required test protocol, we will not monitor the next test chamber. You will be entirely on your own. Good luck.
I hope they maintain that, because... I'm not sure if I could stand being watched anymore. Anymore.
Vital testing apparatus destroyed.
It is. Alright, let's get up there. Let's fire the portal. And then fire the portal. Give me my cube. Number one. Number two. It's that simple, guys. It is, I swear. Hear the radio.
As part of a required test protocol, our previous statement suggesting that we would not monitor this chamber was an outright fabrication. Good job. As part of a required test protocol, we will stop enhancing the truth in 3, 2. Vital testing apparatus destroyed.
See, I have a feeling that we just got screwed on this one. I'm gonna try reloading that one. Real fast. think you want to do is fire a portal at the radio.
Vital testing apparatus destroyed.
Real quick, let's solve this. Solve it. On the button. Where it is. Might be down here. Oh yeah, there it is. See, that's how you get her done.
As part of a required test protocol, our previous statement suggesting that we would not monitor this chamber was an outright fabrication. Good job. As part of a required test protocol, we will stop enhancing the truth in 3, 2...
Over and out. Dude, you don't have to make that sound. It already does that. Right, sorry.
While safety is one of many Enrichment Center goals, the Aperture Science High Energy Pellet seen to the left of the chamber can and has caused permanent disabilities such as vaporization. Please be careful.
Aha! See if I can knock that radio down. There's a radio up there. Of course not. Anyway, alright, so these energy balls will kill you if you hit them, but you have to use them to power these catchers. That'll open doors and lower lifts and do all that business. All that good shit. So watch. There it goes. Yeah!
Unbelievable. You.
Subject name here.
Must be the pride of.
Subject phone call here.
Got it. My radio. That's really obnoxious. But anyway, we made it. All right. And what's interesting, though, is that I just figured out that that's what those radios do, like, right now. I knew it was an achievement, but I didn't know what it was for. Now I'm kind of finding myself, since I played through the game and I know how to get to the end, it's a new challenge.
Warning devices are required on all mobile equipment. However, alarms and flashing hazard lights have been found to agitate the high energy pellet and have therefore been disabled for your safety. Good. Now use the Aperture Science unstationary scaffold to reach the chamber lock.
I hear the radio. Is it? It's under the stairs. That's nice. Something's telling me I'm gonna have to take it through the ceiling. There it is. It's a modem. Remember modems back in the days, guys? Modems. Thank you. remember Unreal Tournament had
Please note that we have added a consequence for failure. Any contact with the chamber floor will result in an unsatisfactory mark on your official testing.
Actually, I'm gonna reload real fast. I gotta make sure I got all the cameras. Looks like I did. Yep. Alright, okay, good. I remember Unreal Tournament had a gun that was similar to this. It was the... I don't remember what it was called, but it was that thing that launched the disc. And then wherever the disc landed, you could teleport yourself to it. And you could kill people with it if you were good at it, and it was called telefragging. It was like the... I don't fucking remember what it was. It was an awesome game, though.
Please note that we have added a consequence for failure. Any contact with the chamber floor will result in an unsatisfactory mark on your official testing record, followed by death. Good luck.
Followed by death? That was rude. Get it! Yeah! And fall. Back. Yeah, there it is. That's what I like. Come on, you. Hate you. Gross puke sludge on the floor.
Very impressive. Please note that any appearance of danger is merely a device to enhance your testing.
Whatever you gotta do to rationalize that, I don't even care.
The Enrichment Center regrets to inform you that this next test is impossible. Make no attempt to solve it.
That's shitty. I want that radio. Let's see, I'm gonna have to...
The Enrichment Center apologizes for this clearly broken test chamber.
Clearly. I didn't really mean to do that. And I always forget to save. Son of a bitch. I had it too. That sucks. Fuck you. So those fields, you can't fire portals through them, and you can't walk through them once you fired a portal or it makes them go away. So that's where the puzzle comes from. That's why they say it's impossible.
Very impressive. Please note that any appearance of danger is merely a device to enhance your testing experience.
Alright, let's see.
The Enrichment Center regrets to inform you that this next test is impossible. Make no attempt to solve it.
I wanna get that. It won't it.
The Enrichment Center apologizes for this clearly broken test chamber.
I'm actually thinking I should have taken it through the other side, but alright, it doesn't matter.
Once again, the Enrichment Center offers its most sincere apologies on the occasion of this unsolvable test environment. Frankly, this chamber was a mistake. If we were you, we would quit now.
First, let's get the cube figured out here. That way, at least I can take the door.
No one will blame. Fantastic. You remain resolute and resourceful in an atmosphere of extreme pessimism.
There it is. I got it. I don't need you and your shit. Loading.
Hello again. To reiterate, previous warning. Momentum.
So this is the illustration of how you have to use forward momentum to launch yourself to certain portals, and you can see on a picture what they have you do. There you go. Yeah!
Spectacular. You appear to understand how a portal affects forward momentum, or to be more precise, how it does not.
Got it. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. Alright, let's do this for real now, huh? Jump!
Momentum, a function of mass and velocity, is conserved between portals. In layman's terms, speedy thing goes in, speedy thing comes out.
Right. Awesome. Did you see that? In. We're going up. Up in the world, you guys. We still haven't yet to get the orange portal. I think it's in the next one. Yeah, it's in this one.
The Enrichment Center promises to always provide a safe testing environment. In dangerous testing environments, the Enrichment Center promises to always provide useful advice. For instance, the floor here will kill you. Try to avoid it.
The floor here will make you die. And there's the radio sitting on the thing.
Vital testing apparatus destroyed.
All right, well, I think this is a good time to cut off now, so when we come back, we'll tackle the rest of the challenge rooms and see what awaits us at the end. I'll see y'all later.